Wireless technology is important to me because over and over again, I see children in the clinic who do really well in pristine acoustic situations, but anytime they're in a noisy situation, they just fall apart. And their parents tell us over and over again that if they're at home in the living room, they can hear everything, but if they have a bunch of friends come over or other family members and there are a bunch of people talking at once, they fall apart. Or the same thing in the classroom. We know that classrooms are really noisy environments oftentimes. Oftentimes the teacher's voice or the signal of interest in a classroom is at the same level or maybe even a little lower in level than the ongoing background noise in a classroom. And children with hearing loss, we know that they need the speech to be 15 dB above the background noise in order to be able to hear well. And they're just not going to get that kind of acoustic environment without wireless technology when they just wear their hearing aids in a conventional fashion. For the past several years, we've done quite a bit of research in the area of wireless technology. And we started out with this research, we looked at what are called traditional systems, where the teacher would have a transmitter that was connected to a microphone, it was located close to her or his voice, it would pick up her voice and deliver it by a radio signal straight to a receiver that the child wore on his or her hearing aids or cochlear implant. And in many respects, it was like the child was right by the teacher's voice where the microphone was, about 6 to 8 inches away. So even if the teacher moved a long ways away from the child, or if there was a lot of noise, the child could still hear really well in that environment. Over time, these systems have evolved. They worked well several years ago, but they developed systems where automatically, as the background noise level would increase in a classroom, the level of the teacher's voice would also increase that was delivered to the child's hearing aid or cochlear implant. And that resulted in dramatic improvements in the children's ability to understand speech recognition and noise. Almost so much that we expected probably that we had hit ceiling levels of performance and there was no more room for further improvement. Much to our surprise, about a year ago, we started doing research with a new digital radio system, wireless system called the Roger system. And the benefit or the improvement that we saw with the Roger system over analog dynamic FM was just as great as what we had seen with analog dynamic FM over the traditional FM systems. We were blown away, and we've seen children's performance and noise taken to an all new level that we never thought we would reach before. One thing that we saw that was a big surprise in our research with this new Roger digital wireless system is that in background noise, performance oftentimes would improve by 25 to 35 percentage points at the higher noise levels compared to what they got with dynamic FM. So we were blown away by that amount of improvement. We had thought that we had reached ceiling levels. We thought that we couldn't take children any higher. And again, it was an example of where we settled for good when we should have been settling for great, which was achieved with the Roger system. Well, in conclusion, what I would say and what we really try to strive to provide at Hearts for Hearing is every single child, regardless of age, regardless of whether a child has already reached a classroom type of environment or if they're at home with their mother all day, we really, our goal is to fit every single child or provide every single child with Roger technology. We know that is one way in which we can help children reach with their full potential when they have hearing loss.